this circle, up, extend, back, boom. Let's have a look at this bit first. Punches, I'm going to deflect it, and most people, as I was saying earlier, might think of a downward deflection, and that's simply going to get me hit. Exactly the same as if you were hitting there, there, both contact points are the same distance. So instead, by doing this, I actually deflect it slightly that way, and it's now actually in line with this arm. So that gives you a perfect idea of where you're deflecting it to. And from there, I can grab the sleeve, that round movement from there, this is a smaller movement, I can break that. I can grab the elbow if he has no clothes. From here, it's very important. I'm turning the whole body. So in other words, I use my whole body to turn. And from there, I will grab, I will control, I will move. Now he's actually quite well controlled. If I try and do all of this just by, I guess, doing something there, it's not going to work. But instead, I use my whole body to there and back. Right. Chin strikes there. Standard logic is we're deflecting, and that whole movement around is I'm controlling the shoulder. You see there, I've already got that. Now I do need to control another point, but this on its own will not be enough. So there. So the standard logic is that I'm actually doing the same thing we did before. When we twist, he's easily pulled off balance. Well, not easily, but more easily, yeah? Boom. If I simply pull on steel like this, he resists, we've got nowhere. So I break structure before I try and unbalance. And that's what's happened here. He's thrown that attack. Yeah, I'm going to put my right leg forward. One, two, and now I've got there. Now from there I want to control, so that's why it's the whole body. I've turned my whole body. I lean into that point, and that's when it snaps. Okay. And I kick in the back of his head. Okay. Many people forget that when you're doing this, you should be turning the body sideways, opening up. And then from there, bam. Yeah? And the reason for that is that this can and should be seen as a deflection. That's the point at which I snap. Again. Back. I want the elbow maybe that way perfectly, yeah? It really doesn't matter. The elbow could be virtually there. It has to be there in order to have no impact. And that won't be the case. Just like that, the way I'm kicking and my momentum is that way, and my kick is going upwards, so bang, you can already feel, you can bend it a bit, that bang, it's already snapping it. There, with the reverse arm there, he was going to move away, and if he doesn't, and the other version is the heel, so I can get him from all distances. And I managed to catch this, okay? What I'm actually going to do from here when I attack this is I actually am kicking with my knee directly underneath. And from the inside, it's the same thing. I'm going to have to attack this quite vigorously to stop that punch from coming in. And curiously, that's the side I'm really worried about. Curiously, controlling that is all I need. I don't need to worry about blocking. I vigorously attack the center line. And from there, if I've caught it, I'm not hitting the groin. The groin is malleable, it's moving. I'm actually hitting him right in between, in the middle of his body, the center point.
Be hit. But the movement itself, virtually identical to...
Yes.
...to not punching, except sideways.
And in fact, that's precisely why this is sideways. It's exactly the same. It's an interesting observation. Good. One, two, three, four, five, six. What happens? to grab there with the second hand. I'm here, I'm going to go 1, 2. So 1, 2. You hold on. That's okay, because I'm allowing, he's coming in with the second one. Back up, arm, go over the top. And on it. Wah. I interrupted. The first part of the movements is there. If I can manage to get that, I'll be very lucky. Truth of the matter is, he wants that there. All I'm going to do is dislodge it. Can you see how it's tight there? There, I get to dislodge it just a little. That's really the function of that movement. This is a small movement, but he can glue it as tight as he likes. And you'll notice that I can shift, if I need to, my body a little bit, and I can still get him a little bit offline. And as long as he hasn't got the second one in place, that's actually quite effective. If the second one in place, he can still dislodge one of them, and that's something. Second point, as he's got me there, I have to reach over there. I've interrupted that. But there, boom, there. Now he might be grappling with the second one and trying to punch. At this point, okay, trying to punch, when I have that, I've got this arm raised. So I've got that natural cover. The best case scenario for me is that as much as I actually get into me. You can see he's missed, bang, yeah? Okay. So, and he's missed with my hand, bang.
Okay, thanks, I'll come in for it.
In for clinch.
So if we go in here,
so you're looking at this.
One, two, you notice how the arm raises? So, one, two, he's now maybe throwing a punch with the hand. That. And if he really knows what he's doing, and I raise this arm, he'll punch straight over the top. But if that happens, I'm that arm anyway. So I know what I'm, so that's that movement, so we're going around. So there. And have I sacrificed the throw? Actually, I haven't. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, same thing. Yeah? There isn't any real difference.
You can recover faster.
Yeah, I can recover reasonably. Let's have a look at a pass now. So, move smoothly, then don't take his back. Okay. What happens from here?
So there. He feels that. So what does the form do?
It does that. So he rides that. And he rides it by raising it up. He doesn't want, he just gets the throne. So now from there, he adjusts himself around. Push. He's in the same position. That back leg is now perfectly poised to kick.
As you sit. Everything needs to do triggers something. So as we look at here,
as you go, a response.
Oh, so it's just going to like this. Oh, just sit forward.
Slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fast.
Yeah.
So show the movement of the arms, Jeff. It's just going. That slight adjustment, isn't it? Small adjustment, bang.
This move can be used not just in the way that we're doing it here, say following up with the kick. This is reasonably benign, just to take them down this way. But there's other ways of, if you're just kind of trying to back someone off reasonably quickly, you just hit them in the pec. Still doing this, but you're just coming through and whacking with the kind of like the Tai Chi push in the pec area. And just push them back there. Or you can use still more of this motion, but just come through past the neck. And then you can, as you force that through,